Hi folks, this is Ronnie from the Electric Harmonica Company, and today we're not talking about harmonicas, we're talking about lasers, because I use the laser to cut the magnets for the pickups for the Harmonicaster electric harmonica. But the laser is useful for all sorts of stuff. This is a 10 watt XTool D1 Pro, and since I have it, I'm experimenting with engraving other stuff. So this video is about laser marking coatings and engraving glass. And I have tested 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 14 different different coatings. The way it works is lasers, unless they're exceptionally powerful, can't engrave or etch glass because the laser just goes right through the transparent glass. So if you want to etch glass, you put a coating on it that will absorb the energy from the laser and heat up hot enough where the glass starts to etch, and even the some of the chemicals in the coating start getting permanently fused to the glass. Now there are professional laser marking materials like Cermark and Brilliance, and those are rather costly, between $50 and $100 for a 12 ounce aerosol can. It's a little cheaper if you buy it as liquids or powders, but there are a lot of do-it-yourself coatings recommended on the internet, like dry moly lube. Some people want to try cold galvanizing, instant cold galvanizing spray. Tempera paint is also very popular. Problem with tempera is putting it down in an even coat. I've figured out that if you dilute it about 1:1 with water, you can use an airbrush to spray. And it works fairly well through an airbrush, so you can get an even coat. And so I've, in addition to the Cermark and Brilliance, I tried a few paints from Montana who make artist grade spray paints, both their chalk spray, which is down here in white and black, and their MTN line of water-based acrylic paints, which actually are convenient because they clean off with some water. Then they're more like chemical paint products, various chalk paints, Rust-Oleum self-etching primer, tester's chalk, as I mentioned, dry moly lube, Rust-Oleum chalkboard, and zinc-it cold galvanizing spray. And so I tested them all. Now, to test them, I used a graphic of Cyberfrog, a comic book character by an artist named Ethan Van Sciver. And I like it because it's got a lot of detail in it. It's grayscale, and it's hard to see if it doesn't etch right. So, and I use the same settings on everything, which was 10 watt laser, 100% power, 40 millimeters per second. As you'll see with some of them, later on, I think I'm going to experiment with going either higher or lower on the speed to see if I can get better detail. That's where we're going to go. So I'm going to go get the glass panels so you can see how they came out. Okay, so we're going to look at the results now. And surprisingly, there were really only two failures. Everything did manage to get a visible image. First, we'll start out with the two failures. This is Montana chalk white, and it left quite a bit of material. There's quite a bit of texture on there, but it didn't really do things evenly with the lettering up at the top. And the other was tester's chalk paint. Again, it worked, but there's a lot of texture. It's kind of hard to clean off. A lot of lint got on it. Might play around with it later, but the results with the other ones are pretty good. Now, generally, with you're going to have either two results. You're either going to get a dark image on the glass, or you're going to get that traditional frosted etched glass look. So, first is the Cermark Ultra, which gives sort of a dark image. There's a lot of detail in here. I'll try to bring it in and reflect it well, but as you would expect from a dedicated product for specifically for laser marking, including glass, it does perform well. And then there's Brilliance Black Metal Liquid Ready. Sorry about that. Don't want to spill anything. No. That was... Okay, Cermark, I got this slightly out of order. Just 1 second, please. Okay, now here's the other professional, what I'd call professional marking thing, Brilliance, which is meant to put a black mark on metal and other items, but it does a pretty good job of doing that traditional frosted glass look. Just to compare the two, see, one is certainly darker than the other. That's the Brilliance. That's the Cermark. Now we're going to look at a few more dark ones with sort of the do-it-yourself sprays. This is cold galvanizing spray. That I'm going to play around with because I think that you can bring out more detail. This is dry moly lube. I just tried this because it happened to be sitting around. Nobody's I've seen has tried this online. This is self-etching primer. What brand is it? Rust-Oleum self-etching automotive primer. Does a pretty good job on the etching part. You can sort of see it reflecting. And now here is Montana's MTN, what is this? Water-based matte finish acrylic paint. This is MTN gray. Actually, the darker the paint color, at least with these acrylic finishes, the lighter, the whiter, I should say. And here's the MTN black water-based acrylic. And to give you an idea, just the difference in darkness between the MTN white, that's the MTN black. So we get a slightly darker image, perhaps because the white may absorb more energy. I don't know. But they're both worth trying, and you should try any one. I mean, they have different results, and none of them are bad, other than the first two chalks. So if you're looking for different results, you might try this one. Now, this is tempera. The results are really nice with that. Tempera ends up with that traditional frosted glass look. Now, if you were doing an all black or all white design, you know, it wouldn't be quite as challenging as all those gray details and gray shades. This is Rust-Oleum chalk. Now, none of this has been tested for durability. I did clean them off with a magic eraser sponge, but this is Montana black chalk, which did come out much better than the white chalk, although it does have, still has quite a bit of texture. Grab the lint off of the cleaning paper towel. And this is bare chalk. So, please excuse the fingerprints, but so, like I said, all but two of them, I think, have, depending upon what you're going after, how dark the image is, how white the image is, what you're going for, it's surprising the number of paints that did well. You might want to avoid the, you know, you might want to stick with the water-based or alcohol-based paints, the professional stuff, the Brilliance, and the Cermark, I should say, Ceramic Mark, and then Brilliance. They do have good results, and they do clean up a little easier. The MTN water-based stuff also cleans up with water, as does the tempera. The rest of it are solvent-based paints, so you need something like lacquer thinner or acetone to clean them off. But they all clean off well. They all have different results. You might want to combine a couple of them. I know that some of the companies that make marking sprays and marking inks suggest masking stuff off and using different sprays for different effects at the same time. And you could probably do that with some of these. But yeah, you don't have to spend, I mean, even though the results with the professional stuff are better. Well, let's show you the results are better, but here's the Cermark. And there's self-etching primer. So, I mean, it's, you can probably see on the camera that there's a little more detail on the Cermark, but there's nothing wrong with the do-it-yourself ones. So that about wraps it up. I'm going to be doing another laser video on a small little accessory that I'm working on. But I have to get the circuit boards. But to make it a little easier to use your rotary attachment with a variety of brands of lasers. So, hope you enjoyed this. And as Lewis Rossman says, I hope you learned something. Thank you.